So good evening from me. My name is Lydia Katsini and I'm a PhD student at KU Leuven Biotech Plus. The work that I am going to talk about today is funded under the PROTECT project and is titled Data-Driven Modeling for the Effect of Climate on Raw Cow Milk Production Traits. A quick overview of my presentation today. I'm going to start with a short introduction on climate change and impact modeling, then talk about the data sets and the pre-processing steps, and then present some results referring to the clustering of the farms, correlation analysis, and some predictive models. And finally, conclusion. So we all know that climate change is here. According to the latest report by the IPCC, published like a month ago, we can see that based on the scenario, the business as usual scenario, for the Mediterranean region, we are expected along 2045 to have up to 30 days or 30 extra days of average temperature with 35 degrees more. So, what will the impact be in the future due to these changes? This is what impact modeling is dealing with. The framework is using climate models that are considering several different climate mitigation scenarios and are providing us with climate projections. And then the aim of our work is to develop impact models that are going to consider these climate projections and in the end quantify a certain risk. The case study for our case is cow milk. And specifically, we are aiming to build models that are accounting for the impact of climate change on yield, milk composition, and the microbiological state, which means that we're accounting for food security, food technology, and food safety aspects. To do so, we need two data sets, a milk data set and a climate data set. Our milk data set consists of 121 farms located in Malta and is accounting for the time span of 5 years. And this is referring to milk variables that are accounting for all these aspects that I referred to before. The climatic variables data set is including several climate variables and is also accounting for the same time period as the milk data set is referring to. And now when it comes to data pre-processing, firstly, we had to screen the farms because not all the farms were having samples for all the time span of the 5 years. Secondly, we had to resample our data set because not all the farms had the same sampling frequency. One farm was reporting weekly, another farm based every 2 weeks. So we had to resample the data set. And in order to get the same sampling frequency for both set data sets, we did that both on the milk dataset and the climate dataset. However, due to this resampling, we gained gaps in our milk dataset that we had to fill in. And also we had to remove some outliers, as you can see in the graph. And lastly, we decided to denoise the data. As you can see here, this is the fat content over time. The black lines are referring to every farm. The red line is the mean trajectory of that content over time. And the blue lines are the mean trajectory plus minus the standard deviation. For this reason, we applied the wavelet transformation. And this is the result after denoising the data. As you can see, we have a better smooth line that is demonstrating seasonality better. And finally, We needed to transform the skewed distributions, like, for example, applying logarithmic transformations. I move on to the results. The idea was to analyze possible relationships among the milk variables among the milk data set. However, when we analyzed all the farms together, the results were not easily interpretable. This is why we decided to cluster the farms based on the average value of the total microbial load. To do so, we used the TSNE method, which is a dimensionality reduction method, and it represents our data in a two-dimensional space. Here you can see each dot representing one farm. And as you can see, three clusters are formed and are based on the value of the microbial load. So we have the high level of microbial load, the low level, and the mid level. So by analyzing, moving on to the correlation analysis, by analyzing each of these clusters separately, we got interpretable results. Here you can see the results from principal component analysis. These graphs indicate the contribution of each of the original variables to the first three latent variables that are forming the reduced space. As you can see, fat and protein seem to be correlated, as well as somatic cells and microbial load with volume and maybe volume with lactose. Also, when we are looking at the covariance matrix of the variables, we can see in the covariance matrix that we have a positive correlation among protein and fat, and a slight negative correlation among microbial load and volume. However, we still face some limitations due to farm variability. These results demonstrate the added value of the clustering we did earlier. Now I move on to the results of the predictive models. Unfortunately, the predictive models were performing well only in two cases. In the case of fat, predicting using partial least squares in order to predict the fat content and the yield. Here you can see the results of the fat content. As you can see, the PLS model is performing well. 70% of the variation of the data is explained. And here you can see the results of the importance of the input variables. So our input variables were the climate variables. Radiation ranks first. However, when looking at the covariance matrix of the climate variables, we can see that all these variables that appear to have low importance are correlated, which means that we should account for their importance altogether. This means that in order to have interpretable results when it comes to the importance of the inputs, we should perform a feature selection in order to actually conclude which variable, which feature is the one that is contributing the most. And then when it comes to the results for yield, here you can see the estimations, the predictive value over the true value when it comes to yield. Again, the model is performing well with 68% of the variation explained. And here you can see the variable, the importance of the input variables. Again, this the same rule applies that I talked about FAT, that we should take into account also the covariance matrix apart from this, because all the temperature related variables appear to be in low contributions, even though we should consider them as added altogether. To conclude, we were able to build impact models for FAT and yield. However, when it comes to interpretability of which climatic factor plays an important role, we should perform a feature selection. For the other variables, mostly microbial load or somatic cell counts, we need to improve our data pre-processing, and what we are aiming to do now, and we are currently working on it, is in building autoregressive models that are considering the history of each variable, apart from and are able to forecast in the future as well. Thank you. If you have any questions.
Thank you very much, Lydia. Does someone have a question? Oh, everything was very clear. I have a small question. When you present your data, we have data that depend on the time, both for the milk and for the climate data. So, as far as I understand, you use, for instance, for the milk data, average values, and for the climate data, something that has a minimum temperature, maximal temperature. Don't you want to use some methods such as PCF for functional data or PLS for functional data that can take the time into account? I'm not sure it's easily available on air, but it exists, and maybe it can be more adapted on your PLS model.
Sorry, there was a connection error after the after the half of your question. I didn't hear. Can you repeat?
I don't remember what I've said. Don't you want to use a PCA or PLS for functional data in order to take into account all the values you have depending on the time?
Yes, the idea, that was the idea, we tried to do that, but due to the increased variability that we have, because the farms, we're talking about many farms and a lot of variability that is included in the data. And what we saw is that through PCA, by accounting also the time dependence, still the results could not be interpretable